What's up? You're watching BrutalBroadcast.com. In your face!
Some 6 feet under right there. A dangerous meeting from the Graveyard Classics 3. You are in the Cycle Realms here on WMNF Tampa, WMNF.org. That's 813-239-9663. For you stoners out there, I'll say it again. That's 813-239-WMNF. I'm making them think a little bit more since they got to do it that way and actually type the words out. Makes any sense?
Yes, it does.
Well, that's the first person to actually agree. What's up, Death Metal Dave in the studio? What's up, man?
What's going on, man?
You doing all right? You said you were. You gave me a call at the very beginning of the show going, I'm going to be late.
Yes, and I'm here now.
And you're here now.
I overslept.
You just said to go ahead and... Yeah.
Couple of beers, a little football, and I overslept.
Dude, that was a good game today.
Did you take a nap in between the game?
I take a nap every Sunday that I come in here. So
thanks to me, he's actually here right now.
Terry Butler gave me a call to wake me up.
That is the voice right there. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, you want the best, you got the best. That is Mr. Terry Butler.
Yo, yo.
And my God. Dave, why don't you give history of... Oh, God.
we're gonna go through the history over the course of the show. But, you know, we got
it's a god. It's a legend.
We're going to be putting him on the spot here in a few moments.
Uh-oh. Sounds dangerous.
Not too bad. Hence, dangerous meeting.
That was the whole thing right there.
Hey, we got some other guests calling in, too. Now, we got Nasty Ronnie of Nasty Savage.
Right.
He's going to be talking about the benefit next Friday night. We also have...
That's at the Crowbar.
At the Crowbar. We also have Kelly from Atheist calling in. That's the vocalist of Atheist. Doing a show on Saturday, and then they're going to do a little tour. They have a new album out.
This is a good month for metal, dude. This is a good month for metal in the Tampa Bay area.
Every month's metal.
Every
month's a good metal indeed.
I think that's the Bears talking.
God, how is this going to go? Massacre, tell me. Come on, Terry. Tell me about Massacre. How was your experience, man?
It was cool, you know. Definitely one of the first bands in the Tampa Bay death metal scene.
Right.
You know, to help kind of start that scene off and... To be part of that is, you know.
I mean, it's just a living legend, just knowing that, seeing everything that's going around and seeing all these young bucks. Yep. That's what I think about is the young bucks.
I remember listening to metal before Metallica was even thought of.
Really?
Yeah.
So. Terry's old school. He's older than old school. Tell us a little about how you got into Massacre. Well,
Bill Andrews, the founder of Massacre, was my best friend. And basically... helping him do everything with Massacre, you know, kind of a roadie type thing. I was playing bass too, and I knew every song, and, you know, the bass player was released. Bill called me up and said, hey, bring your bass and come over, and the rest is history.
Right on. We talked to Rick Ross a few weeks ago,
yep.
And he gave a little history on Massacre as well.
I remember driving out to Orlando with Bill on a mission to get Rick.
Oh, really?
Yep. Because right. Cam was already in the band singing.
Gotcha.
And, you know, Cam's like, hey, you know, Rick's doing nothing. Let's get him. And Bill's eyes lit up and said, you know, hell yeah, let's go. So we drove out there and, you know, convinced him to come to Brandon here and to be in Massacre. And I agreed with him. I said, dude, if you come to Brandon, I'll move in with you and your girlfriend so it'll be even easier and cheaper for you. And that's all I had to say. He came.
About what year was that?
That was 80, I think, late 85. Yeah, right out of high school. Moved in with Rick and Cam.
So we're about to play some Massacre from Beyond. And what song are we hearing?
Chamber of Ages.
Chamber of Ages. Right. Can you tell us anything about that?
No, that is
it's a great song.
It's a great song. That's all I can tell you about that.
All right. How about we go into some Massacre and then...
Excellent.
We're going to have Kelly from Atheist coming up after that, and we're going to talk more with Terry Butler.
Dude, call 813-239-9663. Peace.
You can talk to him.
Do it right.
That's right. This next time you hear us here on WMNF, that's next week, we'll be in the middle of marathon.
Yeah,
I know. This is the time which we really enjoy. But this is the time when when your voice means basically money. I hate to say it that way. But
if you want
to
hear metal, donate money.
Yeah,
which means we need metal. That money.
Well, that's how the radio station goes. You know, we're commercial free. We play everything. This is the most eclectic station in basically the United States.
This station, I've been listening to this station for 30 years.
Dude, give me some, talk to me about radio.
I had a friend that did a kind of a weird spacey show about 15 years ago. He used to play stuff like Steve Roach and all kind of new age stuff, but it's been part of the community forever. So to me, it's part of Tampa. So you need to support it.
Isn't it a beautiful station too?
Absolutely.
And it's definitely a big part of the metal scene.
Oh God! And it's
this is it for what we have.
But the thing is, that's
pretty. Yeah, that's it.
Well, it's also the only free voice that you hear in the community. Even talking to things like about healthcare and everything going on. All the different channels are so afraid to talk about certain subjects because it's taboo. Mm-hmm. But here at WMNF, nothing's taboo. Dude, I mean, that's the only,
We don't have any advertisers dictating what we say and what we don't say.
Oh, fudge.
We still have rules, but.
That's Ron Jeremy Jr. Over there.
We don't have anyone paying the bills.
Dude, you missed his love line last week, dude.
I heard about it.
He was giving love advice on there. Love advice.
Well, ask for it and I give it.
Check this out. We got a special guest on the line. We got Kelly from Atheist. What's up, Kelly?
Hey, what's up? How's it going, guys?
What's happening?
It's, the metal Sunday evening. Got done watching the Super Bowl, and
did you pull for the Packers too?
Yeah, I was pulling for the Packers.
Okay, there we go.
I didn't want to see Roethlisberger have any more love.
Terry, what were you pulling for?
I didn't care either way.
Really?
I like both teams.
The Bucks weren't in there.
Tampa's
so.
My team. They're not in there, so I don't really give a crap.
Yeah, the Bucks were my team.
I think everybody agrees the Bucks were the team that should have went, though.
That's right.
So what's happening, Kelly? You got a show coming up?
We do. It's a really important one. It's the 20th anniversary of the death of Roger Patterson. And ironically, also the very first show we'll do with our new bass player, Travis Morgan. And also the first time we'll be playing songs from the new album. So it's a big night, and it's been probably 20 years since we played in our hometown of Sarasota. The rest of the guys moved to Atlanta, and so it's just me down here now. And when Tony was in a band, Tony Choi, he was in Miami. But so it's good to have Atheist come back home and do a kick off the tour correctly, and with the first show being in our hometown.
And that's at the Cabana in Sarasota, right?
Yeah, it's in a weird sort of as Jen from the Jenny Torches like to call it, a kitschy little motor inn. It's basically an old school motel with a really cool bar in the middle of it, and it just seemed like a great place to play. Very sort of squared off and simple, and but intimate. You know, there's only 350 tickets available, so it's gonna be wall to wall madness. It should be a lot of fun. I'll actually be playing with our new bass player for the very first time on on stage, so hopefully it'll be a. Hopefully it won't be a catastrophe.
It'll be all right.
I hear the kid's really good.
You hear the kid.
he's got to be.
Yeah, we've known him for a couple of years. I met him at Maryland Death Fest, and he's just one of these prodigy kids that have spawned in the last 10 years that are just, these younger guys are just so amazing. The musicianship and stuff is stellar. So it's good to see a 20-year-old just throwing it down like that. Bittersweet with the 20th anniversary of Roger being gone. I mean, that's a lot of time. I can't believe it's been that long. But so we're going to try to make a good night out of it. Saturday night, Cabana, 2525 South Tamiami Trail.
Right on. And speaking of bass players, we also have Terry Butler in the studio.
Mr. Butler, how are you?
Hey, what's up, man?
How you doing, buddy?
All right. We were just reminiscing about Massacre playing a show with Ravage at the Ritz in Ybor, like in 86 or something.
Yeah, I've been noticing a lot of massacre stuff going on lately. Is that all back?
Well, we kind of did a reunion tour, and that kind of fell apart due to Cam. Really? I'm not going to elaborate and all that, but it died a quick death again.
That's legendary stuff, man. Very important part of the vitamins of daily metal life. That was the very beginning of a huge, sort of Tampa explosion back in the late 80s that I always love telling kids about this all the time. Like, man, you should have seen Tampa. You know, when you look back on it, I'm sure Terry would agree that, I don't think anybody realized that anybody was going to remember any of us.
No.
But to be at, 40 years old and talking about it is pretty cool, man. Yeah, it shows you the longevity of metal. Metal really stays forever, so.
We were just happy to be playing a show, let alone think that we'll have a CD out one day.
Sure. And then anybody further than two streets over would know about it.
Definitely, yeah.
Hey, and speaking of other legends, there's a benefit concert going on for Curtis Beeson, drummer of Nasty Savage. And I understand, Kelly, you're going to be in attendance at that show as well.
Absolutely. I'm trying to get most of the band up there for that as well. So we're all coming up, and I highly encourage anybody metal to come out and do what you can to support Curtis. He's, talk about a legend, Nasty Savage in general, just legendary guys that really were the first guys in Tampa to really sell records out of the back of the trunk of their car and kind of get a deal and set a standard for all of us to look at and sort of aspire to be.
A direct result for bands like Death and Massacre and Obituary and some others for even playing music.
Right.
Yeah. They were going against the grain so hard. And, they get left out of the conversations far too much. And it's always my mission to try to explain when people ask what our influences were. I mean, we were hugely influenced. I think everybody was on so many different levels. Even if it wasn't musically, we don't sound musically the same. But, again, I think Terry would agree that just what an impact they had on everything. We used to go to the Sunset Club and just pack it in. And that was before there were circle pits or anything in metal. It was just straight up headbanging. And, Ronnie would just smash TVs everywhere, and it was just a great time. But Curtis needs some help, and we all got to help him in the metal community. We got to come out, and it's at the Crowbar,
Crowbar on Friday. And we're going to actually talk to Nasty Ronnie here in a little bit, and we're going to ask him if he's going to do any TV smashing.
He's probably going flat screen this time.
That's the new age.
Yeah. How the times have changed.
So, Kelly, what do you got coming up for Atheist? You got a new album out, right?
And we do. Yeah, Jupiter. And doing good. And we're getting ready to head out on March 4th to fly up Seattle. And then we're playing the Scion Rock Fest in Pomona, California on the 5th. And then we're coming over to do some East Coast dates towards the 20th of the month. And then we're heading over to Europe. Start festival season over there, so it's good to it's good to have some fresh new material. I mean, we've been reunited since 06 and just kind of out there playing the old songs, but really having a great time, and it'll be nice to inject some new life into the set with the new album. But can't wait to go. We're hitting some places that we've never been before this time, so
well,
great gig, to be able to go play metal and travel through the world. It's
absolutely
heck yeah. Well, it's going to be Beer 30 again in Pomona, because I'll be there with you with Obituary. Which Terry's an Obituary now, but he might partake a little bit. You never know.
There might be a margarita or a White Russian involved.
California, sure. It's California Part 2, Atheist Obituary.
Oh, man, those good times out in L.A., too. I can't wait to go back out. That particular festival, I don't think they're doing that anymore. It was Murder Fest.
That was
a great day, too, because that was, ourselves and Obituary sort of, headlining that day of a festival all in the West Coast. That, the West Coast never really had a lot of love for death metal necessarily, and progressive extreme metal or any of that stuff. So to find ourselves some 20 years later, chilling with Donald and John, like, crazy, A, anybody remembers all this music from back then, and B, that actually had such a huge impact on the European metal scene. Just all the bands from back in the day. When we go to Europe, I'm sure Terry hears it as well, that and anytime you go there, they just look at Florida as being sort of the mecca of so much. And so they're talking about people that we, sort of know on a day-to-day basis, and they speak of them in different ways. Like, it's just so important to those young kids in Europe, the early days of metal, and I think that's a, you know, that's a sign of an intelligent music scene, you know. So
definitely.
Much as people think metal is full of knuckle draggers, they're dead wrong on that.
Definitely.
Hey, Kelly, before we go, we're going to play some Piece of Time here in a moment, but before we go, how can people get a hold of your stuff? Where can they find you on the web? And
on the web is atheistmusic.com, and Jupiter is available worldwide, but it doesn't necessarily mean you'll find it in every store. I mean, it's easy to get on Amazon.com. I highly recommend that because it's cheap and easy and you get it in 3 days. But any cool record store on the planet that carries metal should hopefully have it. If not, they can definitely get it. Down on Season of Mist Records. Really proud of it. You know, it was 17 years that we hadn't made any music together. And so it's kicking and screaming. It's definitely not an old dude's record, that's for sure.
Hey, wait, I'm an old dude. Come on, man.
So am I, that's what I'm saying.
It is an old dude's. It's old and young. Well, hey, man, thanks for joining.
You know, it's like a good bottle of wine, perhaps. You know, it's
yep.
been
exactly.
Stewing for 17 years.
Well, hey, Kelly, man, thanks for joining us. And you're welcome to come in here in the studio and join us for a night and play what you want to hear, which is what Terry's going to do tonight.
Awesome. I would love to do that sometime. And I'll see all you guys on Friday night. And then we're going to round everybody up to come down to Sarasota and, you know, for the Saturday night show. So it's a big weekend of really good stuff.
Me and
I can't believe Obituary's playing.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Obituary's playing Friday.
Show. I missed it, and I was really bummed out that I couldn't see it, so I'm excited to see him on Friday. And Nasty Ronnie and the gang, David Austin.
Absolutely.
I love David. I love Ben. It's everybody. Those guys are just so important to our, you know, what we do today, you know. And I hope kids go back and study those records. And really, the records, you know, you really have to see them live for the full experience. But nonetheless, brilliant musicianship they always had.
Yep.
Cool. We'll go.
All right, man.
All right. Tear it up. Play some good stuff.
Piece of Time right now. Atheist. Mm-hmm.